Hey friends, welcome to another video on the robotic arm. In the previous video, we made an autonomous robotic arm. If you haven't seen it yet, do check it out by clicking on the card above. And if you're new to the robotic arm and want to learn about its making, connections and calibrations, check out the card above. In this video, we are going to show you to control a robotic arm with a joystick game controller which can play games, draw shapes and do a lot more. Time to take control of your robotic arm in your hands and do some exciting stuff. Before moving on, don't forget to subscribe to Stempedia and hit the bell to never miss out on more such exciting projects. Let's begin by making the controller. First, take a printout of the controller and cut it out. Now, take the cutout and paste it on the top of a corrugated sheet to make it sturdy. Then, cut it out from the sheet. Flip the cutout for making the markings to hold the joysticks. Leave 2 cm from the bottom and sides and draw 2 rectangles of 2 cm by 2.5 cm. Next, cut out the rectangles. Now, take the joysticks and remove their caps. Insert the joysticks from below and place the caps back from the top such that the headers on the joysticks point above. Use hot glue to hold the joysticks firmly in their place. Now, let's move on to the connections. Connect jumper cables to VCC, ground, VRX, VRY pins of the joysticks and extend them. Now, connect Evive's 5V and ground to the breadboard. Insert the VCC and ground of the joysticks to +5V and ground row of the breadboard. The joystick on the left is joystick 1 and on the right is joystick 2. Connect VRY of joystick 1 to Evive's A0 pin. Connect VRX of joystick 1 to Evive's A1 pin. Connect VRY of joystick 2 to Evive's A2 pin. Connect VRX of joystick 2 to Evive's A3 pin. Time to move on to the PictoBlox script. PictoBlox is a graphical programming software based on Scratch blocks. If you haven't downloaded PictoBlox yet, go to the link given in the description box or the card above and download it from there. For creating the script, first select Evive as your board, then choose the appropriate serial port. Next, switch to upload mode. To create a script, we must add the robotic arm extension. First, let's make 4 variables, x1, y1, x2 and y2 for storing the values from the joysticks and 2 more for the time and division factor. Next, make 3 custom blocks for reading inputs, initializing and using Evive's display. In the read input blocks, set the variables to the values obtained from both the joysticks. Set y1 to the value obtained from the A0 pin. Set x1 to the value obtained from the A1 pin. Set y2 to the value obtained from the A2 pin. set x2 to the value obtained from the A3 pin. Under the initialize block, first set the variable's time to 40 and factor to 25. Then connect the servo motors to their PWM pins and then calibrate their angles. You can also add an offset if required. Next, set the gripper open and close angles. Set the initial angle for the rotational servo as well. Keep the gripper open and send it to the home position, the coordinates of which are 0, 200, 200. Also, set the text color, background color, and font size. Under the display block, set cursors to monitor X, Y, and Z positions as we will display their values whenever we change the position along any axis. First, drag and drop the when evive starts up. It will make sure that the code executes when evive is switched on. Then, initialize the robotic arm and display. Next, drag and drop the forever block to run the code continuously. Then, drag and drop the read inputs and display blocks. Each time the forever block is executed, the inputs will be displayed. Next, add an if block for checking the values and controlling the arm. The joystick is an analog device. So, to control the speed of the arm, we must use analog values between 0 to 1023. First, we will check if the value is less than 400. If it is, then move the arm by the values obtained by dividing the difference between the joystick value and the center of the joystick, which is 500, by the factor. We are using the division factor to scale down the value. This will make the robotic arm move along the negative x-axis. You can change the values of the factor and time to control the response and sensitivity of the joysticks to your liking. Add another if block to check if the values are greater than 600 to move the arm along the positive x-axis. Similarly, we'll write the code for the y and z-axis. Now, for opening and closing the gripper, add another if block. If the value of the right joysticks along the y-axis is greater than 800, we will open the gripper. If it is less than 200, we will close the gripper. Now that the code is done, upload the code to evive. Now, let's make a gift drop zone at one of the corners. Fill the board with gifts and treats of your choice and start playing. Hey guys, I hope you like this video. Don't forget to share it with your friends and give it a thumbs up. If you have anything that you'd like us to make next, let us know in the comment section below. And for more such exciting DIY projects, subscribe to Stempedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Bye bye.